The joint air attack team effort developed and validated tactics to be utilized by Army attack helicopter teams and Air Force close air support aircraft operating in support of ground commander's plan of battle. The primary objective? Defeat an opponent's armored attack while minimizing friendly losses. Part one of the tactics development and evaluation effort took place at Fort Benning, Georgia, in a non-instrumented simulated threat environment. It was conducted to develop tactics for joint air operations command and control, tactical communications requirements, management of airspace in the battle area, artillery coordination, force mix and target handoff procedures. The second phase was held at Fort Hunter Liggett, California, under instrumented conditions in a realistic target environment. The threat systems consisted of air defense weapons, armored and mechanized vehicles, hostile aircraft, infrared, optical and radar controlled weapons. Tactics developed by the A-10s and attack helicopters have several common elements. Both utilize terrain features to their advantage during attack phases to minimize exposure times to hostile fire. And both depend on the forward air controller and scouts for battlefield disposition of the attacker. Coordination is the key. Situations and tactics were based on opposing forces doctrine, and the scenario was centered around a battalion-sized unit facing a numerically superior force massed for a breakthrough. As the battle unfolds, two of the scouts move forward to make an assessment of the ground situation. The other scouts carry an attack helicopter team leader and forward air controller. The OV-10 FAC, maneuvering outside of the high threat area, provides the A-10 pilots with battle information, direction to the target area, and radio relay from the team leader or ground force commander. Lead elements of the invading force cross the border, and the attack is underway. The attack helicopter team leader receives a situation report indicating a penetration in his sector. The FAC, scouts, and the helicopter team leader flying nap of the earth profiles make contact with the rival force. A request is made for close air support and artillery.
Yankee 5-7, this is checkmate 1-6. Fire for effect. Shift. Target 202. Over.
While artillery fire is adjusted, the scout determines primary and alternate firing positions for the tow armed Cobras.
Blue 2, got a ZSU, 598754.
Roger.
The attack helicopters engage the hostile air defense systems.
The 2 is firing off, 2.
Okay, Thunder, the NAS up for the artillery gun target line, runs to the target from the southwest.
With information from the forward air controller, the A-10s move in and cue on the attack helicopter's positions for target orientation and friendly troop disposition. The integrated attacks by Cobras and A-10s creates confusion in the hostile air defense artillery command and control system.
And White 1 will be a fire mission. It'll be about 2,500 meters.
Okay, ABC, 12 o'clock.
Got tanks in the open.
12 o'clock,
right?
I got him.
Fire
I'm engaging the tank.
You're cleared on, Thunder.
Okay, missile launch. I'll watch your time.
With command and control of the hostile air defenses disrupted, the defensive umbrella collapses. Enemy ground systems are now fair game for anti-tank weapons on the A-10s and Cobras.
Okay, I have a T-62 in the trees. Range about 270 on a 010 azimuth.
There you go, hanging straight.
Friendly forces continue to pour it on. The addition of aerial anti-tank firepower to ground anti-tank firepower breaks up the massed attack, stops the momentum, and prevents the hostile forces from driving home the attack. The joint air attack team provides a new dimension in firepower integration, attack helicopter teams and close air support aircraft to defeat an opponent's attack force. they work the same airspace, delivering their lethal payloads and providing mutual support while saturating the enemy's air defenses. Effectiveness in combat will require a total team effort. The key to that effectiveness is joint training. This training has demonstrated that attack helicopters and close air support aircraft, functioning as an integrated team, provide increased combat capability to the ground commander and greater flexibility in defeating the enemy.